Hello, welcome to another video.
I'm Gamir and today I will show you a little unboxing. So here's the thing. Inside this box, we get a paper. Yeah, a paper for some shipping information. And if you recognize this company from eBay, then you can guess what it is. It is the Galaxy S6 Active. I gotta clarify that this is not a used S6 Active. This is a refurbished one. As you can see, it's a little bit dirty, and on the front there's a little bit of damage. And also there's another thing that I gotta mention, that since this is refurbished, if I press here, you see it is moving a little bit. I don't know if you can see that, guys, but the screen is like, it's like moving. Let's see, get here. You see this? It's moving a little bit. So yeah, the glue is not like completely like placed there. So I'm going to put the phone here. Meanwhile, it boots. So let's just turn it on. I test the phone a little bit, so everything works. So I factory reset the phone again. Let's see, what else do we got in the box? We got micro USB cable. The issue with this one is that it doesn't look like a normal Samsung. No, it's not like the normal ones. And some bubble wrap. For some reason, they didn't put in that one on with the phone. I'm going to move all that away. And then the box as well. So, I'm going to show a little bit of the setup here. A little bit, because I have to put some credentials and stuff. So here's the S5 Active and the S6 Active. By the design, you will see that it looks... it look about the same. I picked the same color, like the gray color, because that's the only color that they always have used for all the active models. So we can compare them more of the same. Yeah, they look very similar in this hand compared to those two. They have the active key, but it is bigger here. And I actually use the S6 Active before I got the S7 Active, the one that is very used. And then after that was the Galaxy Note 9. As you can see, it will require some Wi-Fi connection, so let me put the password on here. And there you go. It's a little bit slow because I just connected to Wi-Fi. Oh, wait a second. I was about to do the NFC thingy that I transfer my files. Maybe I can. Let's wait. Oh, all right. It still required to put me an email instead of doing the NFC thing. I put the phones together and then. Oh wait, it's actually trying to beam something. Nothing. Absolutely nothing. So I will set up my information there, and then I will let you know my opinions about the phone real quick. Okay. So be right back. Alright, now I finished setting up the phone. I didn't add my account yet, but here's the thing. It has a very smooth transition and everything, so let's check the settings and see if this got the latest version. Probably it does, just that the issue is that the OTA on the AT&T is like very drunk when it's out of the United States, so I will say that it is on the latest version. That's a complete lie. I will manually update it to the latest security patch, because the one that it has here, June 1st 2018, like I doubt it. So yeah, the screen looks really good, like new, but this is not Samsung screen, so I guess it's kind of looks very shifted on the colors. No, I don't notice it on the camera, but no, I think it doesn't look that bad. So yeah, everything is by default right now. So it's kind of slow because just finished setting up, and it has a NuGet, which looks kind of like the audio, which I like. I actually like Samsung experience. It is pretty good looking and stuff. It has better support for Teams and everything. So as you can see right here, it will say 7.0. No, that's not the one. I wanted to touch on this. So yeah, NuGet. So yeah, the phone, during the time that I use it, it has a really good camera, 16 megapixel, before they then downgrade to 12 megapixel on the other phones here. For example, let me take a picture of the Note, fake Note 9. Oh, it detected a face here for some reason. Very good. I don't know if you guys can notice it, but like, the details on this is totally epic. You can actually see every single detail. Those complete 16 megapixels. Wait, it took another picture now? Now, here's the video size. Here's another thing that I like about the phone. Yeah, it is 16 megapixels. So here's another thing about that I like about this phone. It's like 60 frames per second recording. Yeah, the S5 supports 4K, but this when they started adding 60 frames per second record, it looks really smooth. I remember when I first saw a Galaxy S6, I was like, oh, let's see, and then I clicked and then there was like a 60 frames per second option. Now here's the selfie. It has a really cool feature here, so as you can see me here, but here's something that they don't use now, and it's taking a selfie with the heart rate sensor. So if I touch it, well, I guess maybe it's because it's refurbished of something, but it does that thing. At least with the version that I got, the one that I got, it was the second one, because the first one I broke it because it was a refurbished one and then it got water damage. So the other one was a used phone, and then it was in pretty good conditions, a little bit of scratch, but that was okay. So I used it and the phone had water resistance. It had that feature that I could use the heart rate sensor. The picture looked very, 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 very detailed. The phone design, I like it, especially on blue, but I brought it in black because the other ones are the other color black. So for now, that should be it. The next phone I'm going to do is the S7 Active. Oh, and also I gotta show that it works the wireless charging. So for now, that should be it. Thank you for watching the video, and subscribe if you want more content like this on the way. And after I finish collecting all the Active, I will do a very cool video. So the other one left is the S7 and the SA Active. Those two, I will try to get it used or brand new, because the issue is that I don't want the refurbished one, since those actually I wanted to have the water resistant and the plastic screen, because they started using plastic screens since the S7 Active. Well, they still got glass underneath it, and this corner of the screen, I can really notice it, that it has that gum there, that the adhesive. So yeah. So yeah, that should be it. That's everything, and thank you for watching.